Back in the 1940s, a hypothesis emerged that the human body contains a fourth state of matter, plasma, in addition to the three commonly known ones. Hence, the later term biological plasma or bioplasma appeared. Despite extensive theoretical and experimental research on it, there is still no unified explanation of its processes and mechanisms. While the term bioplasma is rare in recent scientific literature, related phenomena are still being studied under different terms, such as the plasma-similar state of biological matter, ultra-weak emission, biophotons, and many others. Plasma-similar states in living matter were confirmed experimentally over time, but there are still gaps in our knowledge to be filled and big discoveries to be made, as there is data that it has direct involvement in anomalous phenomena. The very existence of such plasmatic states suggests that life can change in appearance. Not only that, thanks to fundamental key elements of life that are not dependent on organic matter and the system's overall shape, there might be life on Earth that we are not yet aware of and not recognize as such. A new interdisciplinary field emerges that may provide evidence that living organisms are created by nature within an electric skeleton and bioplasma-related phenomena. This emerging area of research has already yielded a number of interesting findings. Certain experiments suggest that the electrical characteristics of cells might contain a sort of micro-hologram of the framework in the structural grid of bioelectricity. But to fully understand its role, scientists may need to rebuild the foundations of biology by incorporating computer and information-based approaches that rely on bioelectricity and subsequently on bioplasma. For more than 20 years, a Nobel laureate, Albert szent-györgyi, had been relentlessly pushing physics into biology, and it was him who emphasized the significant role of bioelectricity in this context. He based a portion of his arguments upon the work done by the famous physicist Léon Brillouin, thereby prompting biologists to investigate his pioneering research on electrons and energy levels, which were named Brillouin zones. A biological cell in this special space, similar to how a room can be divided into smaller cells, the boundaries of this shape are related to the pattern being studied. The Brillouin zone helps to describe the behavior of waves in this pattern. Within this shape, there is a surface that shows where electrons with the same energy are located. It is important because it helps to understand why Brillouins had been insisting that semiconductors existed inside the body, an idea that was confirmed in the recent studies. A semiconductor is a material with electrical conductivity between that of a conductor, like copper, and an insulator, such as glass. Our current electronic devices wouldn't exist without them. By introducing impurities into the crystal structure, its electrical properties can be altered in useful ways. Semiconductors are necessary for the ordered flow of electricity. And that energy can move through protein molecules is another experimental fact now. Szent-györgyi expounded on the presence of plasma within every molecule of the body, proposing that each molecule contains an electron gas that pervades the entirety of the molecule. This electron gas, which is a negatively charged plasma, is distinct from the ionized, positively charged plasmas, since electrons always carry a negative charge. This declaration was groundbreaking, as szent-györgyi argued that every cell and molecule in the body was electronic and contained plasma. These ideas were deemed too radical for the scientific community and were not widely acknowledged, though. However, these concepts were not forgotten. In this joint paper, Dr. Alexander Boichenko shares the following experimental results of his research. The known methods of studying physics of plasma of condensed media were used to experimentally prove the existence of a plasma-similar state of a biological matter by example of plants and their systems. One of the basic properties of the local action on bioplasma of plants is identified, namely the property to change its structural organization, thus creating conditions for various vibrations and waves propagation in bioplasma. To sum it up, He found that plants and their surrounding media with ionic conductivity, like electrolyte solution, soil, or nutrient media, contain a system of electrically charged particles that interact with each other in a way that's typical of plasma. It's also important that the structure of this bioplasma makes it similar to the cold plasma made in a gas barrier that is not in a state of balance. Dr. Boichenko noted that by the concentration of electrically charged particles, plants are close to doped semiconductors. The process called doping means that the semiconductor materials are modified by adding small amounts of this or that substance, so the strength of the electric flow could be varied and fine-tuned. This not only brings structure into bioelectricity, but also makes the existence of a fourth state of matter called plasma in living matter possible. The author's research shows that because a plasma-like state can exist in the space inside and between plant cells that create a strong crystal lattice, and this allowed him to experimentally prove the existence of bioplasma in plants and their systems. A key characteristic of a plasma medium is its ability to excite and propagate different vibrations and waves. This property was once used to experimentally demonstrate the existence of plasma-like states in various condensed materials. The experiment was based on principles used for detecting different wave phenomena and processes in the plasma of metals and semiconductors. However, what sets this experiment apart from previous ones is that the whole plant was used in these studies. He observed a phenomenon similar to helicon waves, a type of low-frequency electromagnetic wave that appears in an uncompensated plasma placed in an external permanent magnetic field. This is a significant finding. This proves that not only do plants have bioplasma, but they also possess electromagnetic integrity and can interact with each other in a coordinated manner. Besides the wave properties, plasma can also emit light in different ways. For example, in gas discharge plasma, light emission is the main way to know if it exists and to get information about the particles in it. It was back in the 60s when scientists found that plants and animals can also emit light without any external stimulus. They called it ultra-weak emission, or biophotons. This is also a very important phenomenon, and while the scientific community is still arguing about its source, the plasma nature of biophotons was demonstrated in the recent experiment using onion roots as an example. In the peer-reviewed paper, Dr. Boichenko reported results of his experiments in which, using the special photography method, plasma formations were registered in onion roots, and their existence was proven. Specifically, plasmoids being released from the cut roots and then dissipating in space. In the photo, bioplasma is clearly evident, taking the form of a distinctive torch with glowing plasmoids coming off it. Plasmoids' presence suggests that charged particles were in an excited state and concentrated in small areas behaving collectively, which is inherent in plasma. If not, the film would show tracks from particles that move independently, aren't related, and usually scatter in various directions. The paper also mentions the following. The photos of ultra-weak bioluminescence from uncut root tips are equally informative. From it, one can see that the overall structure is similar to the previous image, but the localization of the glowing areas on the growth zone has a more voluminous and symmetrical arrangement in the form of cones, with increasing brightness towards the top and a rounded base. It should be noted that none of the 50 photographs showed torches with plasmoids, characteristic of freestanding plasma formations. And the need for drastic measures to extract plasma formations from them indicates the stability of the latter in the organism's life processes. As seen from the experimental results, during the destruction of a biological object, not necessarily mechanical, energy can be transferred in the form of radiation through plasmoids, which in turn can be emitted from the biological object, in our case, from onion roots. Hence, there are grounds to assume that it is in the same plasma-like state within the biological objects, presumably forming their energetic framework. Using the photographic method, plasmoids in a free state have been registered in the onion root tips, which likely indicates the plasma nature of ultra-weak bioluminescence. End of quote. But before we dive into ultra-weak light emissions and biophoton research, it's important to understand the substance in which these bioelectric and plasma effects occur. This substance we are referring to is water in a very particular state, ice.